Today, ladies and gentlemen, we're breaking down my favorite utility of all times. Guys, if you don't own any utilities, now is the time to consider it because they generally outperform the market. So let's jump right into it. Welcome back, passive income investors alike. Today, I want to talk about my favorite utility of all times. If you watch any dividend investors, guys, like PPC Ian, they're always talking about companies like Southern Company. The utilities in general, guys, have outperformed the markets, and it's something that I've been more looking into lately, and this has been one of the first stocks I ever bought. I've talked about that in the past on this channel, which is Northland Power. Today, guys, we're going to look right into this. I think it's going to be super fascinating and interesting. If you are specifically a dividend investor, these are the kind of companies you want to buy in your portfolio, or at least have a piece of it as your portfolio, because their starting yields are usually around a 5%+, which essentially just means if you need some capital right now today to utilize, well, utilities would probably be a good little section in your portfolio. And everybody has kind of what I would call a cash cow in their portfolio. For instance, if you know Warren Buffett, he owns a lot of stocks that don't pay a lot of dividends, but he owns Geico. He's probably using that as his cash cow to basically buy into other stocks. We all need these as part of our portfolio to essentially keep growing it when we don't have capital to inject into it, in my own personal opinion. Let's just really quickly jump into this utility. So, company's called Northland Power, ticker symbol is MPI. It usually trades right now between the $24 and $25 mark. Right now, as I looked at it, I think it's trading at like 24.5, might change by the time I make this video, guys. Now, the market cap sits right around a $4.4 billion, really small cap. This is not a large company. $4 billion is a lot, but I don't usually like trading companies in the millions. I have one company in my portfolio right now worth $200 million, really small cap company. I try and avoid those because they come with a lot of risk, whereas these companies are a little bit more stapled and a little bit more renowned and resilient because they've been around for a little longer and they have a little bit more girth to them to protect them against any economic storms that may come. At roughly a 16.3 PE, which is actually a lot lower than the peers. I think Southern Company trades somewhere around the 20s. A lot of the utilities tend to trade a little higher in the 20s. This company's got a really nice PE for a utility. Right now trading about a 4.9% dividend yield, right around that, again, 5% mark, guys. If you buy it on the dips, you could probably get it a little over 5%. There's 179 million shares outstanding. Not a crazy huge amount, actually, with 290 employees, which is really impressive for the income this company is able to sustain. And I love essentially just taking their income and dividing it by the amount of employees, because it's nice to see how much an employee makes the company, guys. And the less employees and the higher the income, usually the more resilient a company is, in my own personal opinion, again, guys. But they have a revenues of about $1.4 billion. I think that was as of 2017. That was some of their income statements, guys. This is a company that's got about 8 billion, don't quote me on this, I'm just going off the top of my head, but they have over $10 billion in assets, and they currently have about $8.8 billion in liabilities, so a really kind of close liability to asset range. As we all know, the utilities usually do, guys, because they trade on a lot of debt to build a lot of these projects, and some of the projects that Northland Power is involved is usually strictly natural energy products, though they do get involved in a little bit of gas. They're mainly involved in solar, wind, what's the other one? Thermal. Those are the three major things this company deals with, and I like that. One of their biggest projects right now is a Germany project. They're building, like, I'll just throw it up on the screen. They're building a ton of wind turbines out in the seas there, guys, because they get a lot of high winds, and I think out in those seas they're about, I don't know how far out in they are, but I think the waters are like 40 meters deep, and they're building these massive wind turbines that will get constant hydro 24/7, pretty much 7 days a week, guys, because thank God for those tides that create those winds, which makes a very good cash cow for these guys. It much allows us to see that there's probably going to be some dividend increases into the future. This company hasn't had a large dividend increase over time, but honestly, for their equity growth and the dividend they yield, I think this is a really good company. Their balance sheet is very healthy, in my opinion. And there's one thing that this company does that most utilities don't, and that is just their return on equity, guys. This is kind of a company that has about a 20% return, and its peers get about a 10% return. So essentially, they trade at almost double the revenues that most utilities do. I just think that this company is like a moat. Like, it's not going anywhere. A lot of their long-term debts are fixed rates, so they can't really get hit too hard on interest rate hikes. This company just got a lot going for it. I've owned it for the last 5 years, and I plan on owning it for the next 5 years, guys. Like I said, Southern Company is my other utility. They're the two utilities I own right now. I'm currently looking for another utility I want to add. I usually like trying to find three stocks in each sector. I don't want to own any more than three or any less than three, and usually what I'll do is I'll make one of them the big moat, the one that I like the most, I buy the most of, and then usually the second one be in that in-between moat. Like, I won't put a ton of money into it, but just enough that it's worth owning, and then usually I like owning one more that maybe might be a little bit more risk, a little bit more growth, a little bit lower of a dividend. So I usually own a smaller piece of it, and I usually do this with every sector. Like, again, I've talked about the drug sector, guys. I own BTI, British American Tobacco, Altria Group, and my more of a higher risk one I would consider it would be STZ, Constellation Brands, for more growth than dividend. And this is essentially what I've done to build my portfolio. Now, I don't know what kind of utilities you guys like, so I want you to let me know in the comments section below, what's your favorite utility? Do you own any utilities? Do you plan on owning any utilities? And other than that, guys, stay super cool, stay super awesome, and if you live in Canada, bloody well stay warm, and I will see you tomorrow.